This is how to relate Kp and Kc, equilibrium constant in units of atmospheres and equilibrium constant in units of molar. Determine the value of Kc for the reactions below. Okay, there are two ways to write the formula. We can write Kp is equal to Kc times RT to the delta Ng, or rearranging it, we can write Kc is equal to Kp times RT to the minus delta Ng. I guess it'd be better to use this formula on the right side because this is the one that gets me to Kc. So for this first one, Kc is equal to Kp. Let's see, that's 0.82, and units are 1 over atmospheres, or atmospheres to the minus 1. And now I really need to figure out delta Ng for this reaction, because it's going to be RT to the minus delta Ng. So let's see, I have 2 moles of product gas and 3 moles of reactant gas. So this is essentially going to be equal to 0.82, 1 over atmospheres, times RT to the minus 1, which is a plus 1, so just times R times T. So let me work that out. 0.82, 1 over atmospheres. The R that we're going to use is 0.0821 atmosphere per Kelvin molar, and our temperature is 300 degrees Kelvin. When I punch that into my calculator, I get 20 point, not very much, but it's only good to 2 sig figs, so I'll write 20 point. And let's look at the units. It was 1 over atmospheres. Those are going to cancel out. Temperature is going to cancel out. Now it's 1 over molar. Oh, that's good. That's really the way the unit should be. If it starts out at 1 over atmosphere, it should finish 1 over molar. Okay, let's try the next one. Kc is equal to Kp RT to the minus delta Ng. Let's see. My delta Ng. I have 3 moles of gas, and I'm going to 2 moles of gas. So this time my delta Ng is a plus 1. So I'm really going to take this RT to the minus 1, which is essentially like dividing by RT. So for this particular one, my Kc is going to be equal to Kp divided by, or times 1 over RT. All right, once again, let's put in our values. We have 7.7 times 10 to the minus 6, that's in units of atmospheres, and I'm going to divide it by my R, which is 0.0821 atmosphere per Kelvin molar, and also by the temperature, which I'm now working at 35 degrees Celsius, so that's 273.15 plus 35 Kelvin. Okay, I'll plunk that into my calculator, and I come up with 3.0 times 10 to the minus 7. Let's look at our units here. I went in as atmospheres, so I ought to come out as molar. But did I? Okay, atmospheres divided by atmospheres cancels out. Kelvin divided by Kelvin cancels out. And what I've left with here is essentially a 1 over molar, which you may realize flips, and we wind up with molar on the top. So, excellent. Our units work out, and this would be the second answer.